$18 billion in income tax cuts could start flowing into bank accounts as early as next month. Labor has signalled it will pass the government's tax plan as the political battle over the rest of the budget begins.
Raining on his parade. The Prime Minister and Treasurer woke to a grey Canberra to sell a budget bleeding red ink.
Do you think you spent enough money last night?
Well, we spent what we needed to.
The billions in spending and a $280 billion collapse in revenue delivered staggering budget numbers. A deficit of $214 billion this year, rising to $480 billion over 4 years, driving gross debt to a peak of $1.7 trillion in 2031. Labor hopes to tattoo the debt number on the Prime Minister.
Why is the Prime Minister racking up $1 trillion of Liberal debt during the Morrison recession?
It's not a title Scott Morrison is willing to wear.
The blow of the COVID recession around the world, something the Leader of the Opposition is oblivious to.
Few argue that the government had any choice but to empty its coffers.
Of the two mistakes you can make, right, spending too much and spending too little, history would say it's better to spend too much.
And the budget is the government's bridge between providing economic life support and recovery.
This is a longer term plan for Australia's economic recovery, not just today, not just tomorrow, but the future.
Over just this financial year and the next, $213 billion will be thrown at income tax cuts, business tax write-offs and deductions, a wage subsidy for young workers, building road and rail, and a host of other measures the government says will tally to 950,000 jobs. Many are enthusiastic.
Absolutely the right budget for the right time. It's going to instill confidence, it's going to inspire hope.
Some are crying for more.
Really disappointed that the government did not take the opportunity last night to announce a permanent increase to the job seeker rate.
Labor says it will pass the government's income tax bill, clearing the way for money to start flowing into accounts by November. But the budget politics has just begun.
OK, how do we build a stronger Australia? What's the big reform measure out of this budget? I can't see one.
The opposition leader gets his chance to outline his plan tomorrow night. Chris Yuleman, Nine News.
With a focus on jobs, a key plank of last night's budget was a wage subsidy to help get young people back to work. Nine News has spoken to businesses in hospitality and manufacturing who've welcomed the scheme as they try and recover from the pandemic.
It's been a city institution for our movers and shakers for decades, but times have been tough at Machiavelli Restaurant as COVID-19 wreaked havoc on hospitality.
It's happened so fast. It was almost like a tsunami without that warning.
But now the recovery. Restaurants do rely heavily on young foreign travellers to fill the ranks of wait staff, but they've all disappeared, making the government subsidy to encourage businesses to hire young unemployed people even more welcome.
It could be a starting point for the young Australians to move into and discover hospitality in a new way. If, as employers, we can give them that opportunity now through an apprenticeship.
Under the JobMaker program, businesses will get a $200 subsidy each week to hire a worker aged between 18 and 30 for a year, $100 for those aged 30 to 35. WYSIWYG 3D is an Australian manufacturing success story. Using its scanning and printing skills on dozens of international films, it also makes 3D printed ears for children. It lost an apprentice before COVID, then shut down during. Now looking forward to hiring again, even before business fully recovers.
There's still a lot of unknowns for business at the moment, so having that support, a little bit of confidence to say, okay, well, you know, they'll support us, that makes it much easier to say, yes, let's get going.
There is a note of caution here, though, too.
It's really important that employers are employing people for the right reasons, that they've got a skills need and they're not simply just taking on a young person because there's a subsidy available.
Apart from the focus on jobs, the other is on getting people to spend. And no one's looking forward to that more than our retail sector. And never more than in the lead up to the Christmas retail period.
This period is going to be a live or die period for retailers, a make or break. And up to two-thirds of the profit are made during this next quarter, so it's vital that retailers perform, otherwise they may not have a business moving forward.
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.